In this video, we are going to establish the relationship between A, B, and C, where A is the major axis, B is the minor axis, and C is the distance of the focus from the center of the ellipse. In order to establish the relationship, what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider a ellipse. So here's a picture of the ellipse where you can see P and P dash is the vertex of the ellipse, which is also the major axis of the ellipse, and A is the end of the minor axis. So basically, when major axis and minor axis intersect, they intersect at the center of the ellipse, which is point O. Now what I'm doing over here, I'm considering the foci F1 and F2. So as you can see, OA is B because this is my semi-minor axis, and F1O is basically C, which is basically the distance between the focus and the center of the ellipse. So as you can see, triangle AOF1 and triangle AOF2. These two triangles are right triangles. So basically we can use the Pythagorean theorem, and if we do that, we can find the value of AF1, which is this side, and AF2, which is this side, and both are the same length, which is basically a square root of B square plus C square. Length of semi-major axis is A, and length of semi-minor axis is equal to B. The distance between the foci is equal to 2C. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider this point P at the edge of the major axis, or I can say basically I'm taking a point P. So let us consider a point P at the major axis of the ellipse. Then F1P plus F2P, which is basically over here, is equal to, I can write F1P as F1O plus OP, which is over here, plus F2P, which is over here. As you can see, F1O is C, which is over here, and OP is my semi-major axis, which is over here. So basically, we can write F1P, which is these two terms over here, as C plus A. And my F2P is basically, I'm subtracting this distance from the semi-major axis. So I can write basically F2P as A, this whole distance, minus OF2, which is C. So basically F2P is equal to A minus C, which is over here. If I simplify this expression, C will be canceled out and I have only A left. So I will write A plus A, which is basically 2A, which is over here. Now let's consider the point at the minor axis of the ellipse, which is basically point A. So we can use the definition of the ellipse, which is basically says that F1A plus F2A is equal to F1P plus F2P, because the definition of the ellipse says that the sum of the distance from the fixed point is constant for an ellipse. And that's what we are doing. We are taking two points A and P, and the sum of the distance of these two points from focus F1 and F2 is basically constant. So it doesn't matter where we consider the point, the sum of all the distances will be equal. So that's why we can write F1A plus F2A is equal to F1P plus F2P. And as we know, F1A and F2A is basically square root of B square plus C square, and F1P plus F2P is basically 2A from here. So we can write F1A plus F2A is equal to 2A, and F1A F2A is basically square root of B square plus C square. So let's write it over here. And if we do that, we will write a square root of B square plus C square plus a square root of B square plus C square is equal to 2A. And if we simplify, we will get, implies that 2 square root of B square plus C square is equal to 2A, which simply means that a square root of B square plus C square is equal to A. And if we simplify further, we can write A square is equal to B square plus C square. Now I need to find the value of C, so I can take B square to the other side, and simplify and I can write C is equal to square root of A square minus B square. And this is the relationship between semi-major axis, semi-minor axis and C, which is the distance between center of the ellipse and focus of the ellipse.